live now in a post-Christian culture where God's not sovereign. No, I'm sovereign. Listen to me very carefully. If Jesus is not Lord of your life, you have a form of insanity. A renouncement of God is a renouncement of your humanity. I feel like I'm taking crazy pills. Look at our culture. Look at just what happened over the last 24 hours, the tragedy. It seems that so much of our society is inverted, and I think we would definitely say perverted. Let's face it, when God is trivialized, absurdity rules. Today, I'm going to talk about a very controversial subject, a very controversial and polarizing person. I'm going to try to tackle the question, what would Jesus say to Joe Biden? He might walk up to him and say, "Hi, Joe. I'm not sure we've ever met." He would say the same thing, though, to Joe Rogan and Donald Trump, Tiger Woods, maybe even you. A lot of us know about Jesus, but do we know him? Do we really know him and talk with him and walk with him? Are we his children? Before I get into this, though, I want to tell you something. Some of you are like, "Okay, I can't wait, Ed, for you to slam Joe Biden." And others are like, "Oh man, be kind, thoughtful, and considerate." So for some people here, I can't be direct enough. For others, I can't be copacetic enough. Here is what I've learned over the years of speaking. In fact, I just got back from Northern California Friday, and then I spoke a little bit at Alasso Ranch at our Sisterhood Women's Retreat, which was great. I think I'd rather go to a women's retreat than a man's retreat, but that's beside the point. Anyway, though, whenever I talk, it's hilarious because people are so selective. They sometimes will parrot back to me what I said, and I go, "I didn't say that." I mean, I don't even really read the comment section online, but now and then our social media team will tell me what people say, and I'm like, that's not even the context. So make sure when you listen to my words today that you just listen with an open mind and an open heart, because we've been learning around here what Jesus would say to these icons. Basically, it's the same thing he's going to say to you and me. The first thing I believe Jesus would say to Joe Biden is, you must be born again. You must be born again. If you think about John chapter 3, for example, a man named Nicodemus, who is a member, in essence, of the Supreme Court back in the day, he came to Jesus at night. I call him Nick at Night. He was asking these questions, and he was going back and forth with Jesus. And Jesus proclaimed in John chapter 3, verse 3, these words. He said, "I tell you the truth. No one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again." Nicodemus was a brilliant man. And most scholars believe he became born again. But When Jesus said those two words, those two controversial words, born again, Nicodemus was like, I can't put my life in reverse and return to my mother's womb. What are you talking about? Jesus begins to unpack that. I believe he would deal with Joe Biden on that very subject. He might say, Joe, if you were to die tonight, why should I let you into my heaven? I think Biden knows about God. He's a nominal Catholic. He would call himself a Christian. But for that matter, most people in the Metroplex would call themselves Christians, and I'm not sure that most people in the Metroplex are believers. As significant as our birthdays are, and you know, we make such a big deal about our birthdays, don't we? Especially due to Facebook and Instagram. We have these birthday weeks and even months. I mean, it's great, this is my personal opinion, celebrate your birthday, you know, have a cake, a few gifts, but wow, after that, woo, cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, a birthday bonanza. One day someone said, I can't believe you said that. They were telling Lisa and I this, it's my birthday week. I promise you. As significant, though, as our birthday is, our spiritual birth is even more significant. So when I'm born physically, I have a physical nature. I'm born again. I have a spiritual nature. So I have a fleshly nature because of my birthday. I'm a 61 model. March, write this down. March 16th, 1961. Appreciate your pastor. 1961. I also have a spiritual birthday, a divine nature. I had two parents. I didn't choose my parents. I didn't choose my family. Didn't choose my heritage. Didn't choose that. I just, by the sovereignty of God, was born in it. I did, though, choose to be born again. It's a choice that Joe Biden has to make. It's a choice that you have to make. Our parents, the Word of God, and the Spirit of God. The Word of God, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. That's Jesus. So we have two parents. So in our nature, we're like our parents. I mean, I have some characteristics in my mother and father. I can't help it. I love to draw and paint. My mother was a fantastic artist. I wasn't forced to do it. I chose to do it, but I have some, you might say, marginal artistic talent. Okay. I've always liked athletics. You look at my family, we have a very athletic family. My grandfather raced against the great Jesse Owens. He was a track star, a football star. So I kind of have it in my genetic makeup. I was not forced to do it. I chose to do it. And then, you know, in marriage, how many times have we done this? You're acting like your father. That's your father. And, you know, when you start doing that, it gets dirty, doesn't it? That's just like your mother. We can't help it. Hey, students, you're turning into your parents. Your hair might be purple. You might have tats all over you. You might wear the latest and greatest fashion, but you're turning into your mom and dad. Now, hopefully, we're, you know, our parents 2.0. We can learn from the good, the bad, the ugly, but am I making sense? So if I'm born again, I'm going to exhibit the nature of Jesus. If I'm born again, we're not saved by works, we're saved by grace through faith. So Joe Biden's answer, your answer, my answer, if Jesus said, why should I let you into heaven? Well, it's not by works. It's because I know you. I don't just know about you, I know you. But are you exhibiting his nature? And Jesus would probably go down the list in your life and also in Joe Biden. Do you have a thirst for righteousness? Is your focus to glorify God? Do you have a hunger, a passion for the Word of God? Is church a part of your life? Do you revolve your life around the only thing Jesus ever built? At the women's retreat, I sat at a table over breakfast with several ladies, and one asked me a question. They said, "Well, Ed, I want to ask you this question. What would you tell me to do? What's the most important thing I could do with my family?" I said, "That's easy. Introduce them to Jesus Christ and revolve your life around the church." Church attendance should not be optional, flippant, casual. It shouldn't be a back burner issue. But Jesus would look into the eyes of Joe Biden and say, "Joe, you must be born again." And if you are, are you exhibiting the fruits of the Spirit? And he would ask that question to you. Okay, he would say something else too. Jesus would say, "You know, Joe, I want you to think about this. I'm sovereign and you're not. The government is not sovereign. You're not sovereign. I'm sovereign and you're not." Jesus has to be Lord of our lives for us to understand what life is all about. Why is the world going crazy? Why the absurdity? Why the mass killings? Why the heightened desire for suicide, drug addiction, porn addiction? Why? We've disregarded God. We've kicked God out of our culture. We live now in a post-Christian culture where narcissism rules. Where God's not sovereign, no. I'm sovereign. Think about Jesus might say Nebuchadnezzar in Daniel chapter 4. Nebuchadnezzar was a king, and just to give you the cliff notes on his life, Nebuchadnezzar made a statue of himself. See, narcissism is really old, isn't it? And he demanded that everyone bow and worship him. He basically said, "When the music starts, worship me." And sadly, I think there are a lot of pastors in our world today who would take a knee in our woke churches. Sadly, tragically. Three people did not take a knee: Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Because they didn't take a knee, they were thrown into the fiery furnace. They were delivered from it miraculously. And Nebuchadnezzar kind of had a mini revival. Then though, he had a dream, and Daniel interpreted the dream for him. And Daniel said, "You are gonna go crazy. You're gonna lose it all." So I want you to think about this. You have idol worship, which is in vogue today. Nebuchadnezzar bowed the knee to himself. Then because of that, you have him being isolated. You have his kingdom imploding. Nebuchadnezzar being by himself, the Bible says, like an ox. His hair grew like eagle's feathers. His fingernails, Howard Hughes-esque, claws like a bird. He was isolated. So think about this. You show me someone who's narcissistic, who's on the ride of pride, slowly but surely, after they go through this high, through this buzz, through this hit, and then they realize, wow, life is more than just stimulating nerve endings. They end up being isolated. And then from isolation, you have, you ready for this? Insanity. Listen to me very carefully. If Jesus is not Lord of your life, you have a form of insanity. Think about that. You don't understand what it means to be fully human. A renouncement of God, and I think about Joe Biden here, is a renouncement of your humanity. It is. So, simple answer to a complex question. Why do we see what's happening in the world today? Just look at it. It's about idol worship. It's about isolation. And then it's about insanity because we've kicked God out. But when I know God personally, when I know Jesus Christ personally, when I say, you know what, Jesus, you're sovereign, you're Lord, you're running the show, then I move away from pride, and then instead of isolation, what do? I have the community of the church, and then from there, I have sanity. I'm self-aware. I have wisdom. I have discernment. I mean, is it just me, or do you look at people and go, this is insane? Our president, who I believe doesn't have the skill set to be president, I don't think Joe Biden has ever had the skill set to do anything he's ever done. I believe that. Okay. But let me say this. He does have the ability to surround himself with the right people, which he has not done. He's pretty much made a leadership blunder at every crossroad. Yeah. And I'll just say that from a leadership perspective. So he's telling me that he doesn't know what a woman is. Insanity. Yeah. He's telling me that it's okay to sexualize children and to mutilate children. He's telling me we have a nation, but our borders are wide open. And hey, we're all for diversity. We're all for all sorts of people from all sorts of situations. However, they have to do what our government says as far as becoming citizens. I think about Marxism and socialism. I don't think Joe even understands it, but Marxism is responsible for over 100 million murders. Name me a place where Marxism works. Yet, at our universities, most of the professors are parroting this. We look at our government, which, you know, as a president or as a government, our elected officials should have some fear or reverence for you and me. Yes. It's just the opposite. We fear the government now. What's happened to us? What's happened to the FBI? What's happened to the CIA? What's happened to Congress? I'm not saying everybody, don't misread me, but I'm telling you, we are in a hellacious situation, and my dear friend, they are coming after us. And Joe Biden needs to wake up and smell the proverbial espresso. I don't say coffee because I like espresso better than coffee. I think Jesus would also say traffic in the truth. Lie after lie after lie after lie after lie. Exaggeration, folklore is what we have from Joe Biden. And I don't mean in his dementia state right now. I followed Joe Biden for decades. I mean, he was making outlandish statements, I mean, years and years ago. But I believe Jesus would say, Joe, you're one prayer away from being born again, knowing Jesus Christ personally. Joe, you're one prayer away from freedom. Joe, you're one prayer away from telling the truth about who you are. Because when you're born again, you gotta tell the truth about who you are. I'm a sinner. I looked in the mirror right before I walked out, put some mousse in my hair, and I'm going, Ed, you are a self-centered, fallen sinner. Joe Biden is too. So it's very easy for us to say, oh, I'm here and Joe Biden's there. We're all sinners. Those of us here who know Christ, we're on a different level. We have a different nature, a new nature. that spiritual nature, but everyone is a sinner. Joe needs to tell the truth about his pain. And I know that Jesus would tell Joe that he loves him, that he feels his sorrow and hurt over loss that he's experienced. And I believe Jesus would say, Joe, run to me. Run to me in your limitations. Run to me. You're over your head. Run to me. I'll help you. Gather people around you who love God and who have wisdom and discernment. But he needs to tell the truth about his pain. Maybe the truth about your problems and his problems. Are you telling the truth to God? I mean, God knows it. I love this verse that we take out of context. The truth shall set you free. That's totally out of context. When you say that, you're saying Jesus will set me free. Jesus is the truth. John 14, 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Truth. The truth. Tell the truth about yourself in your pain, with your problems, and also in your profession. The truth to many politicians is like kryptonite to Superman. Not all, but many, many, many. It's lie after lie after lie, and our government has turned into one big honking court case, and we're stuck with the lawyer's fees. In many ways, it's a Ponzi scheme, isn't it? It's completely and totally out of control. We need to pray for our officials. We need to vote for men and women who underscore and highlight those transcendent values given to us by Scripture. But when you're saying that you're not going to protect the lives of developing babies, when you're saying a man is a man and a woman is a woman, I mean, if I think it, it's real, I guess I'm going to identify as a Burmese python. I guess I'm going to identify as an NBA All-Star. I've always wanted to be one. I feel that. I'm an NBA All-Star. Yeah, no, you're not. You average 0.6 per game at Florida State. You're not. No, but I feel that. You're judging me, man. You're judging me by saying I'm not an NBA All-Star. Do you see how crazy this is? But it goes back. It goes back to who is Lord. Tell the truth, Mr. President. Tell the truth. So what would Jesus say to Joe Biden? Well, he would say the same thing to you, wouldn't he? Have you been born again? Is Jesus Lord of your life? Is he sovereign or are you sovereign? Do you traffic in truth at school, on the team, in the boardroom? When you're making the sale, when you're preaching the sermon, because the truth will set us and even Joe Biden free. Would you bow your heads? Father, thank you for this message. Thank you for this opportunity that we have once again to come to your house. And I pray, God, for President Biden, that he will turn to you, that he will give the totality of who he is to you, that he will surrender himself to you. I pray for revival in our land. God, I also pray for the families and friends of the victims who were tragically taken by insanity, by evil. And Father, comfort them and hold them in the hollow of your hand. We as a church pray for them. And I pray, God, that you would continue to move us and restore us and motivate us and stimulate us to walk with grace and mercy for Christ's sake. Amen.
Hi guys, thank you so much for watching the Ed Young YouTube channel.
That's right, and if you want to be inspired, encouraged, and challenged like never before, subscribe and click the notification button.
We believe this channel can help change your life.